hope you enjoy the Mass. We'll see you afterwards.
There is a place for us, for all the world to see. There is a place out there, I know, some way ahead, for all eternity. We stand, all God's children, together. We're trying to see where we belong, with hills and valleys to conquer. It's time we weather the storm. Everybody's looking for something, oh, something they can hold on to. We're lost in a sea of confusion. It's hard to know what to do. There is a place for us, for all the world to see. There is a place out there, I know, for all eternity. Where do we go? Tell me, sisters and brothers, how much wrong must we do to be right? It's time that we look in the mirror. It's time that we see the same light. I know everybody's searching now. Why can't we just all get along? It's time that we all come together. Time that we sing the same song. There is a place for us, for all the world to see. There is a place out there, I know, for all eternity. Yeah. Whoa. I know, for all mankind, for all mankind, where we can find love, oh Lord, there is a place.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. It's great to have a third Sunday night in the Gospel Choir now, celebrating to an empty church, but a screen full of faces. The last time I celebrated, it was like watching a block of flats and everybody in the window dancing. So let's continue this evening and try to catch the spirit of what we share every Sunday night at the Gardiner Street Gospel Choir. We always begin by quietening and asking the Lord to lead us and guide us in our celebration together. So let's take a moment just to ask ourselves how we are, where we are, and where we wish to be led. Lord, you came to call a sinful people. Lord, have mercy. Lord, you came to heal and to reconcile. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And Lord, you are with us even as we are distant from each other. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Glory be to God, give glory in the highest.
Peace to your people of goodwill.
We praise you, we bless you, we glorify you.
Peace to your people of goodwill.
Yeah.
Oh God,
glorify you.
Peace to your people of goodwill.
Yeah.
O God, heavenly King.
Yeah.
O God, heavenly One.
Yeah.
O God, almighty One.
Yeah.
O God, almighty One.
O God of mystery, out of death you delivered Christ Jesus, and he walked in hidden glory with his disciples. Stir up our faith, that our hearts may burn within us at the sound of his word, and our eyes be open to recognize him in the breaking of the bread. Grant this through Jesus Christ, the firstborn from the dead, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. We listen to the first reading now, which comes from the letter of St. Peter.
From the first letter of Peter. If you invoke as Father the one who judges all people impartially, according to their deeds, live in reverent fear during the time of your exile. You know that you were ransomed, inherited from your ancestors, not with perishable things like silver and gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, like that of a lamb without defect or blemish. He was destined before the foundation of the world, but was revealed at the end of the ages for your sake. Through him, you have come to trust in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are set on God. This is the word of the Lord.
Glory be to you.
Thank you.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Two of the disciples of Jesus were on their way to a village called Emmaus, 7 miles from Jerusalem, and they were talking together about all that had happened. Now, as they talked this over, Jesus himself came up and walked by their side, but something prevented them from recognizing him. He said to them, "What matters are you discussing as you walk along?" They stopped short, their faces downcast. Then one of them, called Cleopas, answered him, "You must be the only person staying in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have been happening there these last few days." "What things?" he asked. "All about Jesus of Nazareth," they answered, "who proved he was a great prophet by the things he said and did in the sight of God and of the whole people, and how our chief priests and our leaders handed him over to be sentenced to death and had him crucified. Our own hope had been that he would be the one to set Israel free. And this isn't all. 2 whole days have gone by since it all happened, and some women from our group have astounded us. They went to the tomb in the early morning, and when they didn't find the body, they came back to tell us they had seen a vision of angels who declared he was alive. Some of our friends went to the tomb and found everything exactly as the women had reported, but of him they saw nothing." Then he said to them, "You foolish men, so slow to believe the full message of the prophets, was it not ordained that the Christ should suffer and so enter into his glory? Then, starting with Moses and going through all the prophets, he explained to them the passages throughout the scriptures that were about himself. When they drew near to the village to which they were going, he made as if to go on, but they pressed him to stay with them. 'It's nearly evening,' they said, 'and the day is almost over.' So he went in to stay with them. Now, while he was with them at table, he took the bread and said the blessing. Then he broke it and handed it to them. And their eyes were opened, and they recognized him. But he had vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, 'Did not our hearts burn within us as he talked to us on the road and explained the scriptures to us?' They set out that instant and returned to Jerusalem. There they found the 11 assembled together with their companions, who said to them, 'Yes, it is true. The Lord has risen and has appeared to Simon.' Then they told their story of what had happened on the road and how they had recognized him at the breaking of the bread. And this is the gospel of the Lord." Allow me a few words by way of reflection following our gospel story. Unfortunately, the care home for Jesuits in Dublin and other priests has been hit by the COVID-19 virus, and we've had 6 deaths of residents in the last couple of weeks. Yesterday, here at Gardiner Street Church, we celebrated the funeral mass for a past member of this community. His name was Francis Keenan, a Belfast man who spent most of his life in ministry in our Zambian mission. While tinged with sadness, especially for his surviving sister who watched the funeral on the webcam, I found the funeral also full of joy. There are people, and often they're Jesuits, whose passing is not altogether a tragedy. Now, that may sound strange, but what I mean is that after a life of service, without a flurry of grieving children or grandchildren, The funeral of a priest is often a joyous affair, the celebration of a life well lived and a generous and good servant of the Lord. In the case of Father Francis, we all knew him for his great humour, his practical approach to life, his lively intellect, and his solid service of the mission. Father Francis was a sound and wise confessor. By that I mean a priest who gave good advice. He understood the human weaknesses, but also had a few tricks and skills for dealing with them. Around the age of 10 years, Francis and his family suffered the Blitz in Belfast, when bombs fell on his locality and destroyed neighbouring houses and took lives too. It was a horror and a trauma. However, at 10 years of age, Francis can remember being disappointed that the bombs never hit his school. At a November memorial service in the Philippines a few years ago, I can remember a very elderly American Jesuit describing all the Jesuits in the local cemetery as good companions. This has a double sense for us because we dare to call ourselves companions of Jesus. Francis was a companion and a good companion in both senses of the term. And this brings us to today's reading, a real favorite for any listener because it's such a beautiful story. It's so warm. There's so many feelings in it. It's above all a story of companionship, of two disciples of Jesus, which becomes an extraordinary companionship when Jesus joins them. And just notice the passage from doubt and fear to a burning heart and then to revelation. And that's the mystery that every Jesuit priest, every human being, every Christian of every denomination is invited to do constantly. Come back again and again as life offers new experiences, new challenges, new joys, new disappointments, and allow our Lord Jesus to enter into that story. Allow him to walk with you and to share your experience as you walk. Hear his words of comfort, of challenge, of reconciliation, of healing, and feel it burn within you. This is no less than God at work in you. And that's the reason why, for Christians, anything short of this encounter is nice, but not what it could be. Helpful, but infinitely less than what's possible. So, for Christians, mental relaxation exercises are great, but they're only the lead-in to the encounter, the meeting with one who is ready to meet us on our terms, with our experience. The question is, do our experiences bring us face to face, side by side, with the companion, the best companion in our lives? Father Francis had fire in his belly, and I thank God for his life and his witness. He leaves a grieving sister, but no children and no grandchildren. As a Presbyterian friend of mine once shared with me, whether as a parent or a single person or a person without children, the Christian is really only satisfied if he or she has passed on the message of life, the fire that's in their soul. And so he said to me, the best thing that we can do with life, preach the gospel, die, be forgotten. It sounds dark, but ultimately, that's what we're happy with most. I'd like to remember at this Mass, especially Kiva Kavner's father-in-law, Sid. We know that he was a great character, and the Facebook posts tell us something about him. And I'm sure that Kiva's family is going to be celebrating him and thanking God for him. So I'd like to offer this Mass with you for the repose of his soul and the comfort and consolation of the family.
Amazing grace,
amazing,
how sweet,
amazing,
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 pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your community gathered strangely in different places. And as you have given us reason for great joy, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in our lives this week. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart.
We raise them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord. But at this time, above all, to praise you especially, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and pleads our cause. He is the sacrificial lamb who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. And so, overcome with joy, and even with all the heavenly powers, we sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy,
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, you who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we're gathered in his name, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to make holy these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing and broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Of blessing. Look with favour on this offering of your church, and grant that we may be counted now and forever among the members of your Son. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, with Dermot, our Bishop, and all of those who walk your ways of faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters. Remember especially Kiva's father-in-law, Sid, and all who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the Apostles, the Martyrs, Saint Francis Xavier, and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him, with him, and in him. Amen. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours forever and ever. I hope that sounded okay. Let's pray to the Father now in the words our Savior has given us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, and grant us peace in our day. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, especially this virus. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you all. And let's offer each other somehow a sign of peace. My brothers and sisters, my friends, behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ spiritually bring us all together to eternal life. There's a nice prayer we're reading after every Mass on the webcam. I invite you to make these words your own. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul.
Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, please come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you now as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
A breath.
here at Gardiner Street Church, we're trying to keep this candle lit for the duration of this crisis. And more or less, we have it in front of the altar all day with the webcam. Let's use it just to remind us of those who have suffered. I'm sure Kiva will be delighted to know that we've prayed for her and for her family, and especially for her father-in-law. It's amazing just to be together again and to celebrate this, even digitally. And I'm really grateful to you all, and especially to the organizing team, James and all of the rest, who have just made this possible. May God bless you, and may God look after you and grace you this week. And may we be delivered from this strange and difficult time. And may we be protected, and those whom we love also be protected. And I make this prayer through Christ our Lord. So, my brothers and sisters, we gather our prayers finally, as we say, look with kindness on your people, O God, and grant, we pray, that those whom you have been pleased to renew by these mysteries may attain the glory of the resurrection, where we shall be one again with those whom we love and who have gone. This prayer we make through Christ our Lord. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Have a great week. Be together. Be strong. Be faithful. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
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 It's you too. Please join in. You know us. I have run, I have gone.
There you go. You think I'd know how to turn on my mic. Okay. Thank you very much for joining us on the Gardiner Street Gospel Choir Mass. We do hope that you'll be able to join us again next week, same time, 7:30 p.m. Please tell a friend. We'd like to see a lot more of you. And it's great to see people tuning in from all over the world. We're very lucky and very privileged to have a full band who play with us. And I'd just like to say thank you very much for them for coming and playing with us on a weekly basis to make the sound that we make that little bit extra. For those of you who are on Zoom, we will have sent you just a little poll. We would like it if you just kind of fill in some of the information. And for those of you on Facebook, if you could please share with a friend, give us feedback. We'd like to know what we can do to engage with you more, our congregation in the world. Take care, have a safe week, and Kiva, our thoughts are with you and with Sid's family. God bless.
Bye.
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 Bye. Everybody.
Bye.
Good to see everyone.
Good to Hello. See everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, Elaine, feelings, mummy.
Hey, yeah.
Hashy feelings. Hashy feelings. All the way from Tipperary.
That's it.
Size of
Oh, look.
Thomas's child.
Gorgeous.
Hello.
Gorgeous.
All right.
Thanks, everyone. See you next week.
Yeah,
bye.
Take care.
Bye.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.
See you next week.
Bye.
Bye. Say
Louise.
Bye, Louise. See you next week, hopefully.
Yeah.
Hey, Louise.
Hey, Marion.
Hi.
Hi, how are
you? Guys.
Adios.
Adios.
Bye.
Adios, amigo.
Bye. See you, Michelle.
See you Wednesday.
Bye.
Have a lovely
bye.
Week.
Even jollier.
Absolutely. Bye bye, everybody.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, David.
Thank you, Jim Bob. See you, Mary Ellen.
Well, it's a lovely party.
I'll clean up after the party. Don't mind me.
Good
morning.
How are you feeling, Michelle?
Still not
How are you feeling, Michelle?